Okay, I'm gonna say this right now. Actinides are just scientists pandering to various people.
Yeah.
I mean, we got American, Americum,
Francium.
Francium. I live on Californium.
Yeah, Californium.
Isn't that like Berkeleyum? Is that just for Berkeley University?
Berkeleyum,
Yeah, it is.
Mandel.
I think
Lawrence.
The Lantanides were just named after people who donated a lot to the laboratories.
Okay. So guys, I was thinking for a scrap mechanic. One, we're probably really tired, so we can't think of too much. So I really liked what we did last time, except for one thing. The weapons scrap were cart. Stupid. We didn't even use them.
Yeah.
I think we should just go scrap carts, no weapons. Except for maybe, okay. like, wheel spikes, because they're easy. You know, kind of the basic, like, bumper cart thing.
Alright.
And then we're also going to have to do several false starts before we go to make sure we're all at about the
speed?
Same. Yeah.
Because
I was substantially faster than you guys because I stayed on the ground the entire time. Because I had training wheels in the back.
Alright, sounds good.
Yeah.
Alright, well, I'm waiting on your server to pop up, Wander.
Mm-hmm. It's loading right now.
I think it's almost up. Yeah, I don't mind playing bumper derps.
Because I really liked the section where Batbeard and I were like
you
neck and neck.
You launched me into space.
Yeah, that too. I will admit, your fist was awesome.
It was cool.
Part of the reason why I don't want to do more weapons is because, like, A, I spent, like, I had to edit a scrap mechanic episode. And, like, cut shit out. I don't do that. That's totally new to me. And so, like, the concept of having to do that was just like, ugh. Also, we should make him big.
The other thing is that the fist is just too awesome.
Mm-hmm.
You can't top the fist.
I can't top the fist. I was sitting there the entire time being like, I want to make a fist. And then being like, no, I can't. I can't do it.
It was awesome. It was really fun to make, and it was fun to use, and it was fun.
You know what? You should have just made the palm.
Oh,
well, bam!
Palm.
Okay,
I made the foot.
So guys, guys, question: do we want to make them like this big, like
big ghosts?
Yeah,
okay.
Big carts.
I mean, if that's the case, like, I might as well just use. Where is it?
Well,
what
you
is it,
could,
two
Effie.
Platforms, 2x1 platform, basically.
I could just use this.
Whoa, game. Are you okay?
Yeah.
What the hell is this?
So Effie.
No, build one new.
Yeah, build a new one, but that's a perfect model, but build a new one.
Yeah.
Also,
yeah.
All the pipes and guns and shit. Well, cool. Nah.
How did you even, like, design that in your head?
I
don't
understand. Just kind of designed it as I went, honestly.
How did you get it to be even, though? Like,
I'm gonna mod.
You must have been very patient.
Processing. Yeah. I got it wrong a couple times. I just had to do it over.
This game desperately needs a mirror mode.
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
I am going to.
Actually,
you know
hold on.
Why not try. I'm gonna try using this thing. Because I built this thing a long time
ago. Nah, Effie, make something new.
No pre-builds.
Yeah, no pre-builds.
Alright.
Well, all that this is going to be once I gut it is...
Okay,
to be
fair, that's just a rolling platform.
Yeah, I'm just going to gut it. So, just, yeah.
Batbeard, like yours is a little bit different. Cause like Effie's
is like a working.
Yeah, Effie's was like good to go.
Okay. This saves me having to remake platform plus turning glitch.
Nope, that won't work.
Do you not have like
and
building that kind of shit down or?
Are there any or no?
I do, but when I'm tired, it takes longer.
Yeah, that would do it.
Are we doing wheel size restrictions or no?
I'm doing 9x3 personally.
Yeah, I'm doing 9x3s. They seem
right. To be a good ratio compared to the size of the platforms that we're using.
Okay.
Oh, this remix is on point.
Is that, I like
very
it.
Very spicy.
I'm assuming it's two wide?
It's two long, one wide.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Might have to turn it up. This one's quiet. There we go.
It's like got that Santana, like, flavor to it.
No, oh shit. I can't get on OC Remix. Can somebody tell me who this one is? Oh, yep. Fuck. Dancing Spirits, DJ Mystics.
Ah.
Got that.
I always mean to like
more Latin than Tim Kaine.
I always mean to like download every single like good remix that
good one.
Yeah, that rolls by. But I always forget to do so. Because what I want to do is eventually make, like, a compilation of, like, all the really good ones that we've always liked. And then just listen to them for a night. Because I think that would be real nice.
That would be very nice.
It would be.
There's been some very good remixes over the years, and there have been some really awful Sonic ones.
Oh, man. I need to do that.
Two playlists, one of which is just nothing but our most hated Sonic remixes.
You know, I would actually listen to that for, like, one joking night of just, like, us kind of weeping.
Aw, Sonic.
The worst Sonic raps that anybody can come up with. Get carte blanche to be like, he's the world's fastest, he's the world's greatest, he's gonna get all the emeralds and he's gonna save us.
Yep. You heard it first, ladies and gentlemen. Birdcatcher's new song.
I have too much artistic dignity to do something like that.
Good. It doesn't suit you. Making bad remixes is for those crazy people.
Question. You guys are on a Yoshi remix right now, right? Because I have to use the radio player.
This is Getsu Fuma Den.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
Never mind. Okay, fuck. Then we're desynced, probably.
That's fine.
Or are you on,
I'm...
OC, are you sure you're on OC Remix and not?
So the website is totally busted for me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cause, it gives me like a could not connect to the whatever service, and I'm just like, god damn it, I want to listen to your music. And it's like,
how
if this problem-
drink cost? Drink is 85 cents a can.
Yeah, there's an actual drink called drink.
No, we're not talking about real drink. We're talking about bird drink.
Bird drink. Oh.
We're establishing more drank lore, because people want to know more.
To be totally honest, the exact measurements on the drank can vary wildly based on Bird's supply of aluminum, and he makes them entirely with his hands, which has some,
unpleasant effects.
Are you saying I'm not a good metallurgist?
I'm
getting, like, sheets of, like, I'm getting, like, rocks of aluminum to work with.
Yeah.
Doing the best I can, bro.
And you're rocks crushing them aluminum? With your little white man hands. I know how that is. I've tried it.
Aluminum rocks.
They're
yeah,
just so
those.
White, Wander. I can't do anything about it.
It's okay. I understand, man.
Your whiteness pervades you. Precedes you, excuse me. Wrong word.
I forget, Bird. Who's...
Pervades isn't a word at all.
What was the, exact ranking of generic white guy? Were you higher?
Oh, hell, I don't know.
Were you higher on the list, or was I? I seriously don't remember.
I think you were higher.
Okay. Because we should probably batten that down someday. For, like, the sake of...
Yeah, well...
Consistency and...
I think of all the things that have ever mattered to the world, battening down that list is, like, the least important thing. But sure, I'll help you.
It ranks decidedly low. Yeah, you're you're not wrong about that one.
Like, I don't think that the newspapers are going to be writing, like, local group of white dudes ranks which dude is whitest as anytime soon as news.
That'd be... I'd be pretty down with getting
at that point. I get the feeling I'd probably be losing faith in humanity. Not that I haven't already.
I thought you meant like losing rank. I was like, are you saying that like you're like spicier than all of us?
He wants to be in the running. I see how it is.
Yeah, clearly.
Fuck. Oh my god, what was that? I hit a wheel and it took me with it. That was new.
Okay.
Yikes.
Take me with you.
I'm glad you came back, Bird. Even if you're snarking hard.
Oh yeah, I mean, I was feeling very, very bored. I was like, huh, what do I do with my life for the rest of my night? I don't know how to comprehend this. Because, like, I'm kind of burnt out on music, working on music, because it's, well, really, really hard. So, I was, like, just kind of sitting around doing nothing, and I was like, I feel better. I'm going to see what they're up to. And then guilt them into playing with me.
Well, your snurkin' presence is appreciated.
Yesh.
Ish.
I said yesh.
Oh.
Oh, I thought he said ish. I was like, that's a classic Wanderbot.
See, that's
like,
what I heard
he
too.
Just complimented me.
Nah, man.
He just like can't handle it for even that period of time.
My backhanded compliments have been at an all-time low recently.
You've been doing much better about it, which I assume is probably due to Shell.
Yeah, maybe.
I mean, Ladybird's always asking me, like, what's Wanderbot been up to lately? And I'm like, I don't know. And she's like, he's your friend and you don't talk to him? I was like, no.
See, the nice thing about, like, me is you know what I'm up to.
It's true.
You know what I've done for the day and will be doing tomorrow.
You're one of the people I spent almost the most time with.
Yeah.
Compared to, like, anybody.
God damn it. Fuck. But yes.
I don't know. Just like, I guess I'm just a shitty friend.
Nah, that's cool. My brother always accuses me of this. He's like, you don't talk to people like normal people would. Like, you don't like ask questions and shit. So I'm like always trying to do it. And I'm like, huh? People never ask me questions about my life. And then I think about it for a bit. And I'm like, there's probably a very good reason.
Yeah.
Because your life is pretty self-explanatory.
Yeah, it's awesome, but it is, not exactly, eventful.
Eventful, yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's funny, I always used to think that a YouTuber's life is so flashy, but at the same time, it's like, it's really
no, it's not. It's like the least flashy thing.
I mean, it might be if you travel a lot, but who wants to do that?
Yeah, like, eventually, once I start hitting up into the hundreds of thousands, I'm probably gonna get, like, pulled on for a ton of conventions, which is gonna be interesting. But, that's a thing for another while. I'm not looking forward to that. That's probably going to be awful.
Probably.
Yeah, because then you're gonna have to...
How many YouTubers, like, don't get sick when they go to conventions.
Pax Pox!
Yeah, I've actually never gotten sick from a convention.
No?
Nope.
No, you're one of the lucky few.
Like, I've been to Pax East three times now. And nope, never been sick.
What am I looking for? One of those moments where it's just late and I don't know what I'm looking for.
It's not that late.
Nah, I stayed up until like 3 o'clock in the morning last night. I don't know why, I just did. So, I don't know. Oh, there it is.
I've been doing that too. I've been writing, like, my
kind of...
Writing it? Eh, not really. Eh, kinda. I think it's harder on Shell than it is for me. But, So I've been writing, like, kind of my experimentalish, like, I'm gonna write a book thing. And my problem is, like, I am terrible at pacing, comparatively. Mm-hmm. So Shell will be like, can we go to bed? And I'm like, but the fight scene just happened. And she's like, okay.
So you're one of those.
You know, that's, something I've been dealing with a lot lately, is just, like, trying to balance my life as a creative person and as a...
Uh-oh.
Oh.
She can hear me from the other room, constantly. Alright. Bird, I goofed.
Yeah?
We heard.
Measure, never, cut, always. It's irrelevant to the shell thing.
The shell thing?
Sure.
Oh, I have a new nickname for Shell. I just thought of it. She can be Shellfish.
That's probably not the first time she's heard that.
Huh.
I don't know. I've never thought of it or heard of it.
Yeah. Huh. I think that's one of the reasons why she originally rejected being called Shell. I apparently accidentally made my vehicle, like, odd. Odd length. Whoops.
Oh,
or
how?
Odd width. I don't know.
You didn't measure it out?
No.
Oh.
You forgot the motto, Bird.
Measure none, cut four.
Damn it. Couldn't get my answer in time. I'm sorry.
I guess that is the motto.
Measure twice, cut the cheese.
Batbeard.
Don't cut the cheese, man. Spectrum. Come on.
It's disgusting.
How else are you gonna get that stinky Gouda?
God, I love Gouda. Gouda's so good.
I mean, you could always, you know, rip the cheese in half with your hands.
Oh! Barbaric!
Wow! Yeah! What are you, a Viking? Jeez!
I'm Canadian, close enough.
Nah.
No!
That makes you French! That's like the opposite of Viking.
No, no. That is one part
of Sheryl Crow.
That is
Canadian,
one part
enough.
Of Canada, and I despise it, so get out of here with that crap. Get out of here.
I struck a nerve. Yes.
Nobody likes the French Canadians. Not even the Canadians.
Not even the
French
Canadians.
Like, honestly, if you ask any Canadian what they think about French Canadians, I can almost guarantee you they will tell you they are dicks.
Le peuple, le mousse.
Le pain. Le mousse.
That is a good foreign word, though.
Le mousse?
Oh, damn it.
Le peuple.
You know, it'd be a lot easier to learn foreign languages if they didn't have different words for everything.
It would be.
That's something that actually always bothers me about learning foreign languages, when they randomly have an English, like, word in there. It throws me off.
That's
so
that's
hard.
That's like my little, like, hanging on. I'm like, yes! Computer! Computer! We speak the same tongue!
But it's like, it's so weird, though. Like, what is it? Like, when I'm watching, like, a foreign film, and they're like, blah blah blah, blah 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 blah, internet! I'm like, what? like, it throws me off my roll really hard.
I just love how you chose that specific thing.
What, that word?
True, though.
Well, no, it's more so that example. I mean, you could have done anything, but it was just...
I mean, internet's one of the more common cognates.
Yeah.
I suppose.
Pretty much anything that, like, originated in an English...
Yeah, technology in America.
Who was I talking to? I was talking to... Okay. God, I don't remember his name, but that's fine. When I was in the frat, one of the guys was Indian. And, you know, spoke Indian, whatever. What is the Indian language called? Hindi? Okay, sorry. was thinking Swahili, and I'm like, that's not right.
Wow.
No, that's definitely
swing
not right.
Swing and not just a miss.
It was painful. Like, I felt it beforehand, and I was just like, yeah, this is not going to go well.
He's like, I'm just
going
to eat
this. He swings and somehow hits himself in the face with a baseball bat.
Yes.
Yeah.
But so, he spoke Hindi, and he was complaining about how like inconvenient it was originally, because he had only come over to the U.S. for college and had to learn like English for it. He said it was super inconvenient because he was using programming as his starting point, because he had learned, you know, programming kind of in English, because otherwise it was going to be like really bad for him business-wise. So, so trying to learn English after learning programming was like the hardest thing ever, because it's like trying to learn Latin after starting with Pig Latin. Like, it doesn't even make sense. Or like trying to learn Japanese entirely from watching anime. I don't really have like a good.
Well, apparently you can do that if you're watching the subtitles. I don't know how people do it, but they do it.
I've watched.
They watch a lot of anime. That's how they do it.
Yeah, I've watched enough anime to know that that's largely bullshit, though.
Yeah, true. That's like saying like I learned like German just because I've sung a lot of opera. Like, no.
Just because you can sing it doesn't mean you know what it means.
That's way often to more true than not.
Okay, so we're still on one engine, right?
Probably. I mean, these are kind of big, so.
They're big, but they're
also
like
ultra light.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. It's true. Like, assuming you're making them right, it shouldn't be a problem.
Well, I'm using tons of ramps, which are probably going to add up to the weight, but we'll just.
What kind of ramps?
It as good as possible. Huh?
What kind of ramps are we talking?
Like the 1x3, the 3x3, that sort of stuff.
So those are light. As long as you're not using the 1x1 ramps, you're actually using nothing but really light blocks, comparatively.
Oh, okay, good.
What are the 1x1? Oh, they're medium weights.
Yeah. It's like medium or heavy. It's stupid.
Yeah, but a single, like, medium isn't gonna really make a big difference.
Did any of you guys know any, like, really hardcore wrestlers in high school?
Oh god, yes I did. Wow, you haven't made me think about that dude in a long time.
I didn't know many, but I always felt really bad for them. With the...
What's that?
The dieting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, they had to go crazy with that.
That's rough.
Wrestler diets
were... went to state like 3 times and lost.
My high school won state for every year, I think, or something like that. Yeah.
Nice.
Whatever it was, our wrestling team was absurd, but it meant that their like dieting thing was like practically a religion. And
yep.
So it was really weird. So I had a pretty accepting high school as far as like weight and whatnot, except for the wrestlers. It's really weird having wrestlers weight shaming each other.
Yeah.
Whoa, ouch.
It is really weird.
It was really strange hanging out with them, because they were all on the debate team for whatever reason.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Okay, I'm sorry.
Wrestle
what?
Debates.
So,
they learned how to, like, settle
and
their,
for my
like,
counter-argument,
scores.
Poop-bam!
So, they
Holy
were...
crap, you couldn't write better SNL sketches than that. Damn, that's awesome.
So the wrestling team met every day at 5. Debate club was at 4. And it was the only club that went that late that wasn't a sport. So, the captain just went one day because he was bored as shit. He's like, I'm just going to be here now. And everybody's like, all right. And then the rest of the team came with. And
that is such a funny, practical story.
Yeah.
Like, the when he laid out like that, it's like, oh, yeah, of course all the wrestlers would be on the debate team.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't they be? The
one shitty part about it I didn't like was we'd go to like
you
national...
were on the debate team.
Yeah, of course. That's why I was hanging out with them. but we'd like share hotel rooms, which was really inconvenient because then they'd start wrestling and I didn't have a choice of who I was rooming with. So suddenly I have a bunch of high school wrestlers putting me into headlocks as I'm trying to like read a book because I'm tired from jet lag and stuff, and it's just like
doesn't sound fun.
It was weird. And then they were trying to convince me to join, and I'm like, I'm chubby as shit, I don't feel like dieting. And they're like,
well, Socrates did say know thyself. So I guess I knew one dude who was a wrestler, and like he had the build of a greyhound. Like he had like a gigantic upper body and gigantic legs and no abdomen. And he was actually extremely good at wrestling. Probably as a result of the fact that he was able to like basically like maintain like the wrestler's body like so well. This guy was extremely emotionally disturbed, huge drug user and stuff like that.
Oh no.
Oh.
He like knew how to control his aggression, so he wasn't like he didn't have like violent outbursts or whatever.
Oh, that's good at least.
But like he was just like just an all around incredibly angry human being. I mean, this is like one of those guys that's like shooting up heroin and stuff in the locker room and things like that. So,
well, I think
I don't know how he was able to compete with sports because you know they drug test you like crazy, but. I guess that he was able to work around that just fine.
I wouldn't be surprised if they drug test for steroids and not.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah,
probably
standardized drug tests. Yeah. I think it's just specifically for
not
steroids,
like a work drug test, you know? Yeah, that makes sense. Right. So, yeah, I mean, last I talked to this dude, like. I mean, he was just saying, like, how, like, his goal in life was basically to buy a ticket to, like, a Greyhound bus to, like, a random destination and just see where it took him. And he was like, I don't care anymore, this is what I'm gonna do.
I actually think about that every once in a while. I really like, taking trains. And I really like the idea of hopping on an Amtrak and just, like, going to Oklahoma and just being like... So what's in Oklahoma?
Yep, yeah. Well, maybe if you do it, you'll run into this dude.
Yeah.
But, yeah, he just, I don't know. One time he said that if I was a girl, he would ask me out.
That's kind of
that was a weird compliment. I didn't know what to say to that at all.
I don't blame you. I wouldn't
know either. Well... I mean, he was actually secretly a wizard and was totally capable of making it happen.
I saw a play about that once.
What?
Yeah, I once saw a musical called, what was it called? Xana Don't or something like that. And it's a play about a gay wizard who can turn people, who can change people's genders.
What?
Well, then.
I'm not even being reductionist. You can look it up and the plot synopsis will be like, Xana is a gay wizard who has the power of changing people's genders.
What?
It's,
all right, then.
It's absurd and weird and ridiculous, but, like, I don't really have a problem with it. Like, I think it's just kind of, like, a weird thing. But
that
it's not, like, even bad.
Movie.
It's just, like,
I mean,
strange.
As long as it's made well, I don't care how weird the concept is.
Yeah, and it was, for what it was worth, like, very well made. It was a musical, and the music behind it was all, bubblegum pop, so it doesn't sound like the Archies and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh. So, it was a weird concept for a musical, but you know what, like... Yeah,
it works,
looking
it works.
Back on it, I think it was cool.
Yeah. I've heard of worse things.
Yeah.
Oh, what's the Avenue Q? I had friends...
Oh,
yeah,
but I mean, that's a classic.
Well, no, all of my friends went off to see Avenue Q without me. Because in high school, most of my friends were girls. And so they all go off to see Avenue.
Say dicks.
Well,
like, oh, okay.
I mean, bit of both, really. But let's not get into that. But so they went off without me, saw the movie, came back, and would not stop singing every song in not the movie, the play. they would not stop singing every song, in the play. So suddenly I have like all of my friends singing like, what was it, If You Were Gay at me or whatever it was, non-stop. I was just like, oh, I don't care how good this play is. God damn, this is annoying.
Yeah, that seems like a really quick way to absolutely hate that thing.
Yep. I felt bad, because, like, it sounded like something I might have liked. Maybe.
Yeah. You know what's weird, though, is I've heard that compliment, that if I were a girl, dudes would ask me out twice.
What was the first time?
Well, the wrestling dude was the first time.
Oh.
The second time was, actually... Well, okay, I won't say it out of fear of potentially embarrassing them, but, they're a fairly well-known, content creator on the internet now.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, now you've gotta say who it is.
I don't know. He's also, if I remember, he's asexual now, so it doesn't even really matter.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Okay. Was this like
that window just closed on me?
Was this early days of Let's Playing for you, or?
Oh god, this was years ago.
Okay.
I've actually always known a ton of like random content creators. Like I know Potter Puppet Pals guy. I know like
really.
I don't know. 6 degrees of separation. You just kind of pick people up.
What Bird's not telling you is he literally goes to internet celebrity lifting contests.
Bars.
No. Yeah, you deadlift Ego Raptor. That's the like that is the goal.
Hell, I mean, if somebody could deadlift Ego Raptor, I would respect the hell out of them.
Yeah, that'd actually be pretty.
Oh, I can't easily.
Pretty funny. Isn't he like?
Because deadlifting isn't actually that like
how heavy
difficult
is he?
To get big weights
well,
on.
Well, so it's not that it's not his pure weight, man. It's the fact that you're lifting a grown human being, which inherently is, oh god, that is so hard. I would do it for fun in college.
No, I could do it.
And I was like going up through the frat, picking up as many like random dudes as I could.
I mean, up to 300 pounds, I could probably do anybody.
Wow.
Hey, if that floats your boat.
Some standards.
Yeah.
That is a hard cutoff right there.
Yep.
300 pounds and you're out.
Well, I mean, after that, the thing is the weight balance would be weird. I mean, it gets kind of hard to pick up somebody if they're spread out.
Spread out?
Because like a bar, everything's concentrated into 2 inches. So...
Just like Batbeard. I'm glad I showed back up for tonight. I get to tell weird bird stories and insinuate that Batbeard has a small hand.
Small wongo?
I'm not sure what to say about it. Probably nothing.
That's a good call.
Saying nothing is probably the best thing you can do right now.
Personally, I recommend weeping uncontrollably, but that might just be me.
Uh-huh.
That's probably just you.
Yeah.
That would be if it
so,
were
are we using thrusters on this one? I missed that.
Oh, we're gonna have boost thrusters. Boost thrusters.
Boost. Okay. And limited to 2?
We'll figure it out as
we
do it.
2 boost thrusters? Okay.
Remember...
This is behaving oddly.
It's gonna be hard to catch up without boost thrusters.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, it seems like a good idea to kind of have them be standard. How do I fit in here? God damn it.
You know, I think I want to remove the shocks on the back. That's not working. Yeah, these shocks are awful.
I don't know why all of my vehicles have been animal-themed lately, but they have been, and it's starting to confuse me.
Are you not making an animal-themed one now?
I'm making an animal-themed one. Oh. And there's, like, no precedent for this happening. It just started. Oh, goddamn it.
Huh.
Oh my god, this
so
is perfect.
You are uncontrollably making animal-themed stuff.
Yep.
Yeah, should we psychoanalyze him? Like, is this like a deep-seated thing or something that we should be rooting out of him?
Well, the fact that he's questioning it is a good sign.
Hey, Bird.
That's true. I want to
show you something. Yes. This is incredibly satisfying.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, baby, I'm all ears.
Get over here. Okay, go to the back. Go to the back.
Oh, yes.
Okay, you see how flush that is?
Oh.
Yeah.
Ow. Oh, the ramps? Oh, I
no,
see.
No, low collision blocks.
Oh.
Yeah.
How do they work?
Low collision blocks are square blocks with the collision of a pipe.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so,
they can, like, scoot effortlessly past things. Got
it. Uh-huh. So if I'm lucky, I can have a tail coming off this sucker.
You furry.
Alright, let's get...
I take offense to that.
Thrusters.
There's no fur being involved in this build.
You fur oppressor.
I... Shark! Did you... Bird, did you see the picture on Reddit earlier today about, like, two surfers surfing over, like, an impossibly large shark? Like, it was a digital painting somebody had done?
Nope.
Oh. I saw it.
Remember, I stopped using Reddit a while ago because I got too annoyed at it.
Oh, right. Yeah, I forgot. I've pared down Reddit to the point where there's only the things
almost
I'm interested
nothing.
In. Yeah, yeah. It's, like, digital paintings... And, it's like digital paintings and not much else.
I just can't stomach it anymore, honestly. Like, I just go on there and I'm just like, this place sucks.
Yeah. I was talking to Shell about that, and I was like, I hate it because I used to go there because it's like, yeah, there's a bunch of different people with different opinions that I'm interested in kind of listening to it. Now it's just this, like, weird echo chamber of, like, every side, not just
anger.
One.
Just angry, angry website.
Yeah, it is pretty angry.
And Batbeard's the source of 98% of it.
What? No, actually, when I first started YouTube, I tried to find a subreddit that I liked that I could get along with and help promote my channel.
What I found
is that people were just sucking my feedback and not giving me any, and I hated that.
So the thing about Reddit is that, as far as I'm concerned, they like original content and hate original content creators.
Yes. Part of it is the consistent perception of people trying to abuse the, like, Reddit system, which actually makes a lot of sense to me. Sort of.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, I mean, remember, I used to moderate the Let's Play subreddit for a while.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
So, like... My perceptions are kind of skewed heavy in one direction.
It's true.
Because it was very, very common for people to show up there and, like, try and tout their stuff and get really angry when people
told it down.
Yeah, when people told them to fuck off. And it was also one of those where it was very common for people to show up. Throw their shit up all over the place.
I was part of this thing called, it was a subreddit, NewTubers.
Oh, I know that one.
Oh, yeah.
And I was there when NewTubers...
That's an okay place.
No, it's not. I was there when NewTubers was founded.
I said it was an okay place.
Ah, alright.
They changed it when I first showed up, like, it was great. Like, for 2 weeks, I had a great time. But then they changed all the rules all of a sudden after 2 weeks, and it was just basically suppressing... Like, you couldn't post links ever. Period. Done.
Yeah,
that sounds about right.
Basically,
I mean, otherwise
discuss.
The mods have to work constantly. Like, it's impossible.
Well, like, didn't they kind of find they kind of had the balance, actually, when I first showed up. I thought that was great. I thought that was fine. But they decided they didn't want that, and it was weird. Like, they suddenly became so academic. Like, at that point, I might as well just go do my thing and not bother with this.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, so that's inevitably what happens to everybody who uses, like, Reddit for, like, content creation.
I knew the person who founded NewTubers, and I told him it was kind of a bad idea originally, because he didn't have much of a plan. He started NewTubers so he could promote his own stuff, which was the problem. Right. Because we had kicked him off of the Let's Play subreddit because he wouldn't stop spamming his stuff, and he didn't like that because he wanted to advertise. And so...
and then eventually his own subreddit becomes, you can't post anything.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's ironic.
Yeah. it was bad, and... I mean, part of it is, like, there are a billion Let's Players in the universe. And there's not enough time for everyone to make it. Sadly. Ish. I don't know. But effectively...
This is true.
You end up with, like, a lot of really desperate people that want to be, like, seen and heard and stuff.
Yeah.
But, they don't have...
Even if there was a Reddit that existed just to be that empty void and satisfy those people, I don't know.
Well...
Doesn't
exist. I was just mad that didn't exist.
Yeah. I know exactly what you're talking about, and we, like, tried to figure shit out like that, because I was moderating the Let's Play subreddit for 2 years, was it?
No, it was only a year.
Really?
Yeah.
Alright. I think I quit.
The problem is that it's just a community of people that wanted to promote and not consume, so it's just like, you can't make that work.
Yeah, you also need an audience, which is the problem. How do you cultivate that?
And the audience is on YouTube, and you can't really get them to make the switch.
Nope.
Yeah, it's a challenging problem. Yep. There does need to be some kind of solution, because otherwise you just have obscurity. And a lot of desperate people.
Yeah.
Yeah. On the other hand, Batbeard, maybe you can feed those hungry mouths just like you satisfy Effie's desperation every night, according to what you said in Gmod.
I still find that extremely weird.
It's more that I just have a very sticky beard that I have to clean frequently.
Ew. Was that supposed to sound less gross?
Apparently. I don't know how, though.
I'm just gonna... be over here working on my shark.
Yeah, probably for the best.
People in my chat were trying to convince me to make a shark. Apparently, they convinced you.
Nah, I wasn't even paying attention. It happened by accident. I did the, like, remember how, like, whenever we make a train? We do that thing where, we have, like, the ramps going kind of, like, along the middle, or however you want to kind of describe that?
Yeah.
To make the like, wedgie look.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I, so I did that, and I'm like, huh, this looks kind of neat. And then I, like, kept going for a bit, and I'm like, I just made a hammerhead shark. All right. Shark.
Remember when I made the sclub?
Fuck, what was the sclub
we were
again?
Trying to make hammerhead sharks, and then gross instead.
Yeah, I remember that. That was a long time ago.
Yeah, it was.
Let's put the thrusters up.
Oh, whoops.
So when you finish your story, Wander, what are you gonna do with it?
I don't know. I mean, realistically, I'll probably put it online or something for people to be able to read. I'd like to actually start putting it up online once like November hits for like NaNoWriMo. It feels it's cheating a bit, but it's like,
I don't know. I don't think I'll have time to participate in NaNoWriMo this year, but I could probably do it next year.
That'd be fun.
Once I have like a job. Maybe do a regular thing out of it. I don't know.
Yeah.
It'd be fun. I did participate in years past, but what always happens is that like midterms hit again, and I'm just like, alright, bye.
Yeah. Never mind. It is definitely a terrible time for a competition.
I know, if they've done it any time of year that wasn't November, you'd probably do it.
But yeah, I've found specifically like writing for a couple hours after streaming has done wonders for like calming me down.
Really?
Not that I'm like terribly stressed out, but it's one of those where it's just like, I don't know. Sometimes we're done with the session, I'm just like, I'm just tired.
Amped? Oh.
Well, that too.
Hmm. Yeah, usually after streaming, I'll be like, oh, I'm gonna go to bed, and then I don't, and I just work on music for hours instead. I don't know. This thing looks pretty stupid. I guess, something that I'm dealing with a lot lately is I'm just kind of coming to terms with the fact that I have a very finite amount of time and a lot of ambitions. And so, like, as a result, I just work constantly and I never sleep anymore.
Yes. One of the actual issues that I've run into now that I'm living with Shell, I don't sleep nearly as much as she does.
Uh-huh.
And that means I go to bed at, like, 3 and wake up at 10. Or...
Yeah. Huh.
Or go to bed later and wake up at 10 or something. I don't know. She, on the other hand, goes to bed at 3 and wakes up at 1. And so I'm sitting in bed from, like, 10 a.m. onwards being like, well, I can't get up because I don't want to wake her up, so I guess I'm just going to sit here reading on the internet. But she doesn't go to bed until I do, so it's just like this awkward catch-22 of like, well, I guess I'm just gonna sit here forever.
Ugh. Yeah, Ladybird used to do the same thing. I would go to bed, like, later and wake up earlier than her. Or no, we would go to bed at the same time, but I always wake up earlier than her. Then you get older and you just stop needing to sleep as much anyway. And then that problem kind of fixes itself. Then she also got a job, which definitely kind of fixed her sleep schedule, but I'm still a student, so...
Yeah.
Yay! Anyway, there was a point I was originally leading up to with whatever I just said, but damn if I remember it now.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So I've gotten a lot of comments lately on our Scrap Mechanic videos complaining about how long we spend building, and I'm like, to me, that's almost the fun part.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Designing is definitely one of those things that it's... It takes a lot of time, but it's also really fun, and it gives you...
So, see, for me, it's banter time.
That's true,
During the actual shit, I'm laughing too hard.
Yep.
It wouldn't make sense to cut that out.
Mm-hmm.
Where all the magic happens.
Like, Scrap is also that kind of game that
if
you're not in it to build, and you're just in it to watch, this is not the right game for you then.
Yeah, I mean, this is basically Legos.
Yeah, dude, I grew up so hard with Legos.
Yeah.
Okay, 4 and then a 3.
This is exactly that.
More or less, yeah.
Okay.
But I just, like, sometimes I just think about all the crazy shit that I want to do with my life and, like, all the projects I have and want to work on. And I'm like, I feel bad if I don't work on them, so I just end up staying up really, really late every single night. Just working like a dog.
Woof.
Yeah. Probably why I'm sick right now.
I don't know. I was sick a couple weeks ago.
Well, if you work like a dog, then
probably not.
You get sick like a dog.
Based on overwork. I don't know. I guess I kind of refuse to believe that overworking myself got me sick. Ever. Because, like, compared to how I was in, like, college, this is nothing. Uh-huh. College was such a, like, hellhole of, like, all-nighters and just, like,
uh-huh. Well, you
stress.
Were an artist. Being an art major is nothing but all-nighters.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the thing is, like, the... You just gotta do it.
Yep. There were definitely times...
Because everyone else is, so...
Yeah, there are definitely times where I felt kind of bad, but I'd be, like, forcing Shell to stay up late with me so she'd get uh-huh. her work done, too. Because, you know, we'd have, like, crazy deadlines. And she'd be like, I'm so tired. And I'm like, you gotta get the work done.
Yeah.
Our teachers were not very understanding or very organized. It was, like, one week where we had, like, no projects to do, and I was actively asking professors to, like, assign shit early.
Yeah.
So that...
Because they're it's gonna get worse. It's gonna get really bad.
And they're like... No, we're talking to the other professors. We'll make sure we're not going to do that to you. And then a week later, when they've all assigned projects, it's like, well, that's just how life is. You're going to have to deal with it.
Mm-hmm. God.
Yeah, I hate that.
Yeah. Oh, it's like the worst justification for everything.
Mm-hmm.
That's twice now it's done that.
Yeah, it's like that one time I had four final exams on
That's
the same
great.
Day.
Ooh, yep.
It was painful.
Bugger.
Like, in my last one, I got, like, the lowest test score I've ever gotten. It was...
It's like a 94.
Alright, well, I gotta start over because my build just evaporated.
Well,
no
way.
Effie, you're lucky you have a backup. However, I'm going to go save mine, come to think of it.
I don't have a backup.
Yeah, you do.
Wait, so yours
Which
disappeared
backup
on
are
you again?
Your other
car.
Oh. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, my build just kind of evaporated on me.
Effie probably did some kind of weird collision, glitchy nonsense.
I think I know what it was. Actually, no, you know what? I don't, because I've never had trouble with I probably put the light instead of light blocks for the suspension bits.
That's
for,
usually how it
wheel.
Is.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh,
wow. What?
I have ultralight on one end. Well, let's see how this goes. I've already saved a backup. No, I've always wondered this. If so you know how you have two blocks you know, one on each end. I don't know if both are danger zone or if only one is danger zone.
Oh, and, both are danger zone.
Both are danger
so you
zone.
You guys look pretty much ready to go, so I'm
Yeah, you can't to... you can't touch it.
Nah.
Well, I'm just gonna keep saving copies of this. I'm surprised it hasn't flown off yet. I'm gonna see if it doesn't for science. I'm gonna sacrifice this hammerhead to science.
Yeah.
Practically what fish are for anyway, right?
True.